Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be showing you how to paint a winter landscape. This video will give you some tips as well as some mistakes to avoid along the way. Let's get started. First, I'm going to mark off my horizon line and my vanishing point. For those who don't know what these are, they are very basic guidelines for most prospective drawings or paintings. A horizon line is just that, the horizon, where the sky and the ground meet up. A vanishing point is the furthest distance within your landscape where everything starts to disappear and get smaller. The first layer I'm going to paint will be the sky, which I'll do in a blue gradient. To create my gradient, I'll be using cyan and various amounts of black to create three different shades. To create a nice clean gradient, you need to be quick so that the paint doesn't dry before adding the other colors to your gradient. This way it's easier to blend out the harsh separation in between the colors. Next, we have mistake number one. I actually started off by painting a base layer of white on my canvas. This is why you're probably seeing little patches of a lighter shade of blue popping up in the right top corner. This feels like a good time to mention patience. Slow down. Give your canvas time to dry in between layers. That way you don't have any color bleeding throughout your other layers. Next, I'm going to start outlining my background, which I've decided mountains would be appropriate given the winter landscape. I'm starting from my vanishing point and working my way outwards towards the edge of the canvas. Don't worry too much about messing this layer up, as it can be pretty easily corrected when you go to fill in the color. Now that my mountains are outlined, I'm going to go ahead and fill in my mountains with just plain Mars black. Now I'm going to do the same on the other side. Next, I'm going to start outlining where my river is going to go, repeating the same process, outlining first and then filling in. This time, I'm filling in using a similar gradient effect with the same blue shades to mimic the reflection of the sky within the water. This time, however, I'm sort of just blotting the color in to give the impression of texture and movement. After this is done, I'm just going back in with some white to clean up my edges of the river and my horizon line. Now, I'm going to mix a little bit of the blue-black mixture with some white to add a bit of texture to the snowy landscape. I'm adding the darkest shades to the edges of the canvas to further give the feeling of depth. using some black to again clean up my horizon line and the base of the mountains. Next, I'm taking some white and adding some detail to the mountains, starting with the brightest white at the very top of the mountain peak, and then sort of dry brushing some texture slightly underneath to show the smaller peaks. Now, I'm going to add a little house in the distance and maybe a tree beside. You can go ahead and add as much to this layer as you want. I'm just keeping it pretty simple to explain the process of the video. Next, I'm going to make my second mistake in this video, which is painting something that I have never attempted before, Northern Lights. So, for the sake of sparing you frustration, please just take a moment to watch in horror. Or, take a moment to Google what Northern Lights look like before you try to paint them. Next, let me introduce you to my third mistake, metallic paint. Now, there's nothing inherently wrong with using metallics, but when you have a super bright light above your canvas, it will visually destroy any hope you had for a clear camera shot of the painting you're trying to show people on the internet. So, what you will do is start with this thin ribbon-like line starting somewhere near your vanishing point. Then, use a small brush or just the flat edge of a larger brush to create lines sort of shooting up from the ribbons. Feel free to use any colors you'd like. Analogous colors are the easiest to use as they will naturally blend well together. For those who don't know, analogous colors are basically any colors that are next to each other on the color wheel. Red, yellow, orange, blue, green, violet, etc. I have chosen blue, green, and violet as my color scheme, although thanks to the glare from my best friend metallic paint, it's a little hard to see. once you think you've perfected your aurora, you can take a little bit of the most dominant color and sort of lightly brush around your lights to create a glowing effect in the sky. And also add a little bit of color to the edges of the mountain and house to again show that reflection on your landscape. Finally, here's a still of the finished product. Not too shabby, but there's always room for improvement, of course. Or always enough paint to cover it up and try something else. Either way, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and until next time, stay safe, stay creative, and thanks for watching.